and who, along with Councilmember Herb Wesson, sort of initiated this dialogue. I understand that pretty much everyone in this room probably has a very strong and passionately held opinion about what to do about short-term rentals here in Los Angeles. There are folks who insist that home sharing and the short-term rental industry is a great thing. It is the thing that prevents them from losing their home, that allows them to pay their mortgage, and allows them to stay afloat. On the other hand, there are folks who feel very strongly that short-term rentals have been destructive to the quality of life in their neighborhoods, and that undermine the very character of a residential.
Airbnb has significantly improved the quality of my life by giving me a place to call home that I can always return to after, you know, weeks and months on the road. And on top of that, just the supplemental income has made it significantly easier to live a creative life. Okay, great. So thank you guys.
We have had shall I say, Airbnb-type rentals in private homes. They are not nice little people that are coming from the Midwest to visit, but rather commercial ventures. The fire danger is my point of severe, severe concern.
I am Barbara Nichols. I'm with the Benedict Canyon Homeowners Association. We would like to have no Airbnbs in our high fire severity zone. It's a very dangerous situation.
There are thousands of short-term rental listing hosts throughout the city, but just four companies account for 92% of all short-term rental advertising. So I urge council to craft a common sense policy that applies to both individual listing agents as well as to the companies that allow them to advertise throughout the city. New rules on short-term rentals will not completely solve the housing crisis or the homelessness emergency, but it is critical that we pass a set of comprehensive enforceable rules. Thank you.
Where should we go from here? The motion by Bonin, Cortes, and Wesson would change the current ordinance. It's a positive step to separate primary residence from commercial.
Most of the people in this room are true home sharers, and we aren't opposed to that when the host is actually living in their own home. However, this isn't what's happening in the vast majority of cases. Since last October, the number of people renting out a spare room has declined sharply from 52% to 36%. What you won't hear is that most of the profit is being made from investors and landlords of rent-controlled properties who figured out it's more profitable to turn affordable housing into illegal hotels.
Yeah. A single woman trying to live my life, pay my bills, and support my children. I'm in need of supplemental income to be able to pay my living costs.
Hello, my name is Amanda Seward, and I'm here wearing two hats, one as a private attorney who has been inundated with tenants who are being evicted en masse in Venice, especially, to make room for short-term rentals.
If you see how many stars you get if you mess up something, you'll know that. You don't mess up when you go stay in an Airbnb home because you'll get this rating and you'll never get to stay in it again. So anyway, I am thankful to Airbnb. But it's to the city council, so I'm a super host, right? So I always want everybody to be super hosts. So in case they're not, we don't mind regulations. I'm just wanting you guys to remember, make sure we don't fall into the NIMBY ideology. Make sure it's really about regulation that will help us.
And what will happen is they will take the information that has been presented here, they will listen carefully, they will collate the results of the online survey, which can also be circulated to any of your friends, and then they will come up with a draft proposal for the City Council to consider later this year.